You know, I'm addicted to nasal spray. I smell everything! I'm invincible! I'm probably going to be a little down until I use the spray again.
Hello, my name is Dr. Eric Nash Tibbett, or Dr. ENT. I'm an otolaryngology head and neck surgeon. I'm going to dissect apart this interesting scene from Family Guy, which actually has medical pertinence and is a not uncommon problem that afflicts many patients. Let's rewatch this scene in segments.
You know, I'm addicted to nasal spray.
First, can you get addicted to nasal sprays? Absolutely. But only to one class of nasal sprays known as decongestant nasal sprays, and only if you use it for more than 3+ consecutive days. Such nasal sprays are available over-the-counter and include afrin, Sinex, 4-Away, among others. They all either contain phenylephrine or oxymetazoline as the main active ingredient. All other classes of nasal sprays are not addictive.
I smell everything!
Is it possible that using such nasal sprays can allow a person to smell everything? Yes. If the nose is completely clogged up or obstructed, it is possible to have a significantly reduced sense of smell. Decongestant nasal sprays will open up the nose, allowing not only improved nasal airflow, but also recovery of a person's sense of smell. Take a look at his nose after nasal spray use. The improved nasal airflow is demonstrated by the marked increase in the male character's nasal opening. However, in reality, this does not happen. Rather, the improved nasal opening is all internal, typically by reducing the size of the inferior turbinates, but also overall decreasing any swelling of the nasal mucosal lining.
I'm invincible!
Although you may feel invincible, in reality, you are not. Rather, the improvement in the sense of well-being all stems from being able to breathe through your nose easily.
I'm probably going to be a little down until I use the spray again.
The decongestant nasal spray's beneficial effects, unfortunately, are only temporary, and if the underlying cause of nasal congestion or obstruction is not resolved, the symptoms will come back. And therein lies the risk of using such nasal sprays for a prolonged period of time. It is natural for a patient to want to use the nasal spray again when it wears off, but the problem is that over time, the patient will find that they will need to use the nasal spray more frequently in order to gain the same improvement. Eventually, the nose becomes addicted to the nasal spray, and it becomes very difficult to stop using it due to the horrible rebound effects of nasal congestion and obstruction. In essence, the nasal spray is now causing the sinonasal symptoms, which can now only be resolved with continued and frequent use. This condition is medically known as rhinitis medicamentosa. Treatment unfortunately requires stopping the decongested nasal spray, whether cold turkey or by slowly diluting the nasal spray with salt water. Safe and non-addictive nasal sprays can be started along with oral steroids to help minimize the awful withdrawal effects of stopping the decongestant nasal spray. Safe nasal sprays to use include both steroid and antihistamine nasal sprays.